Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So another week, another new prompting pattern. And this week I want to look at a paper that tries to use large language models as optimizers. Optimization problems are pretty common in real life. The idea is that you have a parameter space that you want to explore and find the parameters that maximize some objective. The key idea of this paper is that you can describe these optimization problems to a large language model in natural language and use it to explore this parameter space and hence find an optimal or near optimal solution. In this paper, they look at three different examples: linear regression, the traveling salesman problem, and then I think the most interesting example is to optimize prompts for other tasks that you want an LLM to do. Right at the outset, you might ask, well, why do we even want to use LLMs for such optimization problems, especially problems that already have well understood solutions? Linear regression, of course, has a neat closed form solution. Traveling salesman is NP-hard, yes, but it has a number of heuristic solutions that come pretty close to optimal in tractable time. And the authors directly address that. They're saying that the goal of this paper is not to find new solutions for those problems, but to demonstrate that you can use LLMs for optimization problems by using natural language prompts. So you don't really want to solve the traveling salesman, but you want to show that if you had some other optimization problem that wasn't as well formulated as traveling salesman or linear regression, you could use natural language prompts and LLMs to solve them. In fact, they go on to note that using this approach for things like traveling salesman or linear regression has a number of disadvantages, one of which is that if the problem size gets large, you won't be able to fit it in the context window to start with. So keep that in mind as we go through this paper. This is the overall architecture of the solution. The key part of the solution is a meta prompt, which describes the optimization problem in natural language and also contains some example solutions. Think of it as a few-shot prompt. This is given to the LLM, which generates some solutions as well as their optimality score, or how close to the optimum they have come. And these scores are then fed back into the next prompt, and you iterate the cycle until you get an optimal score or close enough to optimal. Let's look at how they set up the problem for linear regression. The goal is, given a set of points, to find a line that minimizes the error or best fits those points. And to do that, you want to find these two values, W and B, which correspond to the slope and the intercept of the line that you're trying to find through those points. This is what the meta prompt for linear regression looks like. There is a task description. So it says, I have some WB pairs and the function values at those points. So you give it a couple of examples, and then you ask the LLM to generate new WB pairs that are different from the ones given and lower the value of the function. And these newly generated pairs are then fed into the next prompt as examples. Now, to me at least, it's quite surprising that this works, but it looks like it does work pretty well. Here, they plot the number of steps that they had to iterate with this prompt, as well as the number of unique points in 2D space that were explored. And they do this for various values of W and B. And you can see that with GPT-4, for example, for most values of W and B, it took somewhere between 4 and 12 steps, and it explored 20 to 40 points in the space before it found a global optimum. They do something similar for traveling salesmen, where they frame the problem in terms of coordinates in 2D space and then use examples of traces through those points and the length of the journey through those points, and ask the LLM to find a new trace that is different from all these given traces and has a total length lower than any of the above. So very similar to how the linear regression problem was set up. Now, traveling salesman is a much harder problem than linear regression, but even here you can see that with 10 or 15 points on the plane, GPT-4 can find the optimum solution or something within 1% of the optimum solution, even for up to 20 points. By the time you get to 50 points, it becomes intractable and the model gives up. So that was just the warm-up. Those were two somewhat contrived examples to show that you can frame optimization problems in natural language and then use an LLM with a meta prompt to iteratively explore the solution space to find a global optimum. Now they come to applying it to a more relevant problem, one that doesn't have a good closed form solution. And that problem is to find a good prompt for various LLM tasks. The particular task they're looking at two particular tasks. One is GSM 8K, which stands for Grade School Math. It is a collection of math and logic problems that is used as a benchmark for reasoning with LLMs. And the other one is Big Bench Hard, which is not a set of problems that is framed as grade school math, but as plain language logic puzzles. And the task they want to solve is to find a prompt that performs best in solving these two benchmarks. Now, people have tried various prompting strategies, things like chain of thought, but they've always had to be imaginative and just try out various prompts to see what performs best. And here the authors are treating that itself, the act of finding a good prompt to solve these benchmarks, they're treating that itself as an optimization problem. And just like how we constructed a meta prompt for the other two problems, we construct a meta prompt for prompt optimization, where we give a few examples taken from the training set, say grade school math in this case, and the prompt that was used to generate solutions for them. We also include previous prompts and what score those prompts achieved on the benchmark. And then we give it a meta instruction to generate a new prompt and apply that prompt to these problems to achieve a higher success score. Here's a concrete example of what that meta prompt would look like. You tell the LLM that its task is to generate an instruction for an LLM, and you give it some previous instructions, i.e. prompts, along with their scores on a benchmark. So these are those examples. This was one prompt and it got a score of 61. This was another one and it got a score of 63. And then you give it an example problem and where you would insert the instruction and what the ground truth answer was and several such examples. And here's the meta instruction to create an instruction different from the ones given above and one that has a higher score. So you're essentially asking the LLM itself to come up with prompts that would achieve better scores on GSM 8K or Big Bench Hard. And by now we're all familiar with the famous chain of thought prompt, which says, let's think step by step. However, with this prompt optimization method, they were able to come up with a couple of new prompts that get better performance than the default chain of thought prompt. So let's think step by step achieved a 71.8% accuracy on GSM. And these two prompts that prompt optimization came up with beat that score. And they're somewhat surprising. Take a deep breath and work on this problem step by step, or break it down. Now, usually you'd have a human prompt engineer trying out a range of prompts to see what performs best, but this is very deliciously meta and recursive, where you're asking the LLM itself to come up with better prompts. So that was a quick look at a paper that uses large language models as optimizers and then applies them to find good prompts that beat the state of the art for various reasoning and arithmetic benchmarks. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you all next time. Thank you very much.